Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. Today's flight is a requested flight service from Miami over to, honestly, I don't know what the airport is called, but it's Mike Kilo Juliet Papa. And, yeah, it's a relatively short flight. About 1 hour and 20 minutes. Pretty much ready to go, lit it up. We're just waiting for the load sheet in less than a minute. And, yeah, it'll be fun. And the airport is obviously Norman Manley International Airport. So.
Hi guys, here's the load sheet for you.
Thanks.
Bye guys, have a safe flight.
Our load sheet has been received. We'll go ahead and enter that information into here. Nothing has changed. 16.6. And our reserves will be 3.8. 6.1. Execute and one limit. And we will now do the performance check or the performance calculation. Takeoff 2, flaps configuration 5. As off condition is dry, and the winds are 130 at 11 knots. The winds are also going to be quite interesting in Manly International, or Norman Manly International. So buckle up for that. It'll be gusting the entire way. Alright, so take off 2 with an assumed temperature of 31 degrees.
Would you like the APU on?
Flaps 5. Yes, please.
Starting APU.
G is entered, and our view speeds are 138, 140, and 146. 146 will be entered into our speed here, and take a page, 1500, and 1500, that is it. Check progress, 138, it looks good, everything is programmed. Accordingly, go to the legs page here, and yeah.
Welcome aboard our flight today. In preparation for departure, please ensure your seatbelts are fastened.
Action these doors. Go and close the doors. That's one thing I miss about X-Plane. When you had like 30 FPS or more, you can actually notice how smooth it is when you pan around. For some reason here, it does not feel like that. It feels really
stuttery. APU on the buses.
Kind of weird. I don't know why. Home prepared version 5. I mean, I haven't used it extensively. Tested a little bit. Performance is more stable. And it is DirectX 12, and DirectX 12 versus Volt can definitely are pretty stable drivers. We'll see. Back to the ground. Please disconnect the GPU. Please remove the external power. Why am I getting... Cockpit to ground.
Go ahead.
Please disconnect the GPU.
Roger. Disconnecting the GPU.
For every FS to crew, it's different. There's the FS lab does not require you to actually have the mic set for the ground crew, whereas here it has been programmed to require it. So, a bit different for different requirements for different FS to crew programs, which is fine. I mean, obviously in the real world, you obviously have to connect the
Captain, the GPU is disconnected.
Actual mic to where you want to speak. So, I mean, obviously this is more realistic than at the slabs in that case. All right, GPU is disconnected. 3 minutes to go. Well, let's go to 1 minute.
Hi, the passengers are seated.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Can we pressurize the hydraulics?
Roger. You're clear to pressurize the hydraulics.
Roger that. Before start procedure.
Check.
Our procedure will be to set the trim at 4.9 units. Basically just 5 units. And that is it. Takeoff cage is set. Before start checklist.
Before start checklist. Flight deck door closed and locked. MCP?
V2146. Heading 092. Altitude 5000. Altitude 5000 feet.
Tickoff speeds?
Set. V1138. VR140. V2146 set.
CDU preflight.
Completed.
Rudder and aileron trim.
3 and 0.
Taxi and takeoff briefing.
Completed.
Anti-collision light on. Before start checklist complete.
Let's go ahead and request pushback. Start sequence is 2 then 1.
Check.
Okay. Cam crew, arm size and cross.
Go ahead, flight deck. Go ahead, flight deck. Ground to flight deck.
Go ahead.
Communication check, please, and confirm that the brakes are set.
Communications are okay and the brakes are set.
Thanks. Roger, facing west. Release brakes.
Brakes released.
Okay, commencing pushback. You are clear behind, and you can start your engines at your discretion.
Start engine 2.
Starting 2. Pushback complete. Starter cut
set
out.
Parking brakes, please.
Brakes are set. Start engine one.
Starting one.
We now request your full attention as the flight attendants demonstrate the safety features of this aircraft. When the seatbelt sign illuminates, you must fasten your seatbelt. Insert the flat metal clip to the buckle and pull on the loosened strap to tighten it up. To release your seatbelt, lift the upper portion of the buckle. We suggest that you keep your seatbelt fastened throughout the flight as we may experience turbulence.
Another thing I like.
Okay, the tow bar is disconnected and the equipment is clear.
Is the fact that textures and modeling.
Go ahead, flight deck.
I think modeling is better done here prepared. But I think it looks better.
Go ahead, flight deck.
It's more crisp.
Doors can be opened by moving the handle in the direction of the arrow. Each door is equipped with an inflatable slide, which may be.
Thanks, so long. Have a good flight.
I think 36 flight decks are always being monitored.
In the event of an decompression, an oxygen mask will automatically appear in front of you.
We'll see some upgraded cockpit textures before KMIA will be real nice.
Go ahead, cockpit.
Starter cutout.
You can disconnect and go to hand signals.
Thanks, so long. Have a good flight.
Flaps 5.
Flaps 5.
So, open the plastic pouch and remove the vest. Flip it over your head.
Control check.
Ready.
And adjust it to the front. To inflate the vest, pull firmly on the red cord only when leaving the aircraft. If you need to refill the vest, blow into the mouthpiece.
All right.
Use the whistle and light to attract attention.
Left.
Also, your seat cushion can be used as a flotation device. Pull the cushion from the seat, flip your arms
ready.
To the strap, and hug the cushion to
light
your
control
chest.
Check complete.
Go ahead, cockpit.
Smoke detectors located in the laboratories is prohibited by law. You will find this and all other safety information in the card located in the seat pocket in front of you. We strongly suggest you read it
before taxi checklist.
If you have any questions,
before taxi checklist, generators on. Probeat on. Anti-ice off. Isolation valve auto. Engine start switches auto. Recall checked. Auto brake RTO. Engine start levers
idle detent.
Flight controls.
Checked.
Ground equipment.
Clear.
Clear. Before taxi checklist complete.
Clear left.
Clear right.
Runway entry procedure.
Check. Cabin crew, take your seats.
I'm doing my taxiing. Not the best, I think, prepared. At least the NGXu does a terrible job of taxiing.
Ready to go.
Clear left.
Clear right.
Take off.
Check. Thrust set. AT knots.
V1.
Rotate. Positive rate.
You're up.
Flaps one.
Flaps up.
Flaps up.
Takeoff checklist.
After takeoff checklist. Engine bleeds. On. Packs. Auto. Landing gear. Up and off. Flaps. Up. No lights. After takeoff checklist complete. 1011. Happy to release the cabin crew?
Negative.
$10,000. Want to release the cabin now?
Negative. No.
Okay. crew, take your seats. Localizer alive.
Flaps 5.
Gear down.
This is, by the way, a bug of the aircraft. Has to do with FCOIPC. Figured it out.
Final approach fix. Height checked. Missed approach altitude is not set.
Got missed approach altitude.
2500.
Missed approach altitude set.
Flaps 15. Flaps 30. Doesn't want to respond correctly, want to act correctly in certain ways, and with flap settings, so we're going to leave it as is, because the pitch would just, in the negatives, I don't want that. We're going to keep it as is, it's fine. Landing checklist.
Landing checklist. Engine start switches.
Auto.
Speed brake.
On.
Landing gear.
Down. 3 green. Down.
Flaps.
30. 30 green light.
Landing checklist complete.
Cleared.
Check.
1,000.
Feet. Not stable.
Plus 100. Minimums.
Ground visible.
Landing.
Check. Brake disarmed. Speed brake up. Reversers normal. Sixty knots. Check speed.
Lights and doors.
Check. Cabin crew, disarm doors and cross-check. Doors disarmed, APU on the bus. We're not at 3 minutes yet.
Shutdown checklist.
Shutdown checklist. Fuel pumps, off. Probe heat, auto. Hydraulic panel, set. Flaps.
Up, no lights. Up. Set and checked.
Parking brake.
Set.
Engine start levers.
Cut off.
Weather radar.
Off.
Off. Shutdown checklist complete.
Alright, that is the end of the flight. I hope you guys enjoyed. It was a pretty smooth landing, to be honest. I wish I, like an X-Men, could replay it. Unfortunately not very possible in this sim. X-Men, I think, is, again, the superior sim. The only thing that holds people back from upgrading. At least, yeah, technically it is an upgrade. But a lot of things that hold me back, especially, are the add-ons. It's really the only thing that keeps Prepar3D going. That's the only reason why Prepar3D still exists. Or FSX in general. Simply because of the add-ons. That's the main reason. But I hope in the future, when all add-ons, or most add-ons, are compatible with FS2020. Apparently FS2020's flight model is pretty much as close as what X-Plane does. Sure hope that that is true. And no more flying on rails. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. And I'm looking forward to the next video. Peace.